American Rangers and guerrillas set off for the American lines with Allied prisoners, mostly Yanks, whom they rescued from a Jap prison camp. In a lightning swift movement, they killed off the Jap guards, and now outmaneuvering enemy patrols, with few stops for food or rest, they push to safety. The rescuers find most of the men in miserable health, those who lived through these years of hell. Food that was brought in is the first want of all these half-famished men. And a cigarette comes next, you can bet, before the Rangers shepherd the freed men on to safer territory. Safe at an evacuation hospital where they can receive further care before heading for home. It's the happiest day in their lives, and for the first time since captured, they can wear decent clothes instead of Japanese rags and have a chance to wear shoes once more. This freedom brought tears of joy to all the internees. And another almost forgotten luxury, after the comfort of a bath, food, and rest, this newfound freedom is their idea of heaven. Sergeant Samuel Ring, formerly of Wilkesbury, is greeted by his two sons who lived with guerrilla bands. Listen to Corporal Cecil Hay.
You people do not realize how happy us boys were when we were liberated. I didn't realize myself until we had arisen and saw the flag that was flying, and then I had to break down and cry.
Sergeant Walter O. French from Arkansas.
Well, about the only thing I have to say, the last 2 years have been nothing but hell. One of the saddest days of my life was when I was taken prisoner. And the happiest day was when I was liberated by the Rangers.
Sergeant Samuel Goldie knows what he wants.
Well, we're finally free Americans. It took them 3 years, but we're sure glad to get out of there. The Rangers came in that night, and it was about as happy a sight I'd ever seen in my life. For 3 years, we couldn't do anything without someone telling us what to do. And now, at last, we can do what we want when we want to. Be sure glad to get back to the United States, where I'll be a free American again, getting myself a milkshake.
Now into trucks for the port and the ships that are bound for home. This is the moment they have lived and dreamed for throughout their imprisonment. The brutal past is behind them.